Okay, I've moved into this space for about 2 months now, and it is time to do a home tour for you guys. Daryl and I, we've been talking about having a home together for the longest time, and thankfully, we bought our very first home this year. The first thing you see when you enter my home are my sunglasses, my collection of key sunglasses. I just got them. Then we have this tray here that I got from, I think, Shopee. It was so cheap to put my car keys and my accessories. And we have this really cute plant here. It's called the mother-in-law's tongue plant. It really brings out the whole entire sideboard situation. And this mirror, this round mirror, we got it from IKEA. It's perfect for the sideboard. Moving on, we have this little Jo Malone section. It's actually one of my favorite sections in the house. We have the lime, basil, and mandarin scented candle. And also, of course, the diffuser, and it is English pear and freesia. As most of you know, it's my favorite scent. When I feel more bougie, you know, I would light up the candle. There's this amazing combination of floral and fruity, and Jo Malone is actually known for their fragrance combining. Instead of just, you know, focusing on cologne fragrance combining, I try to be a little bit more creative and use a diffuser and candle and, you know, mix it up and tailor the scent for my very own home. And as you walk further, you can't help but to notice this beautiful, beautiful illustration. It's from Lindsay. Thank you so much for the housewarming gift. It is just me doing what I love to do, singing and dancing, as you can see. She even got my little signature hairpin. She actually cut out denim fabric for my jacket. And also these sequins. You can see it's really, really intricate, and she actually painstakingly pasted them one by one. And she gave me that rocker slash feminine look. Don't forget to check out her work at Love Lindsay Co. And then we have this droopy looking guy over here. Ever since I left for Australia, I forgot to water it, so it's kind of striving for its dear life. Note to self, buy artificial plants. And we have this rack over here. I got it from Maju Homes. I really like the size and the amount of shelves. Over here we have some photos of, actually just one photo. A photo of me and my parents. I think I was one. We also have this bottle of English pear and freesia here, because sometimes when I'm in a rush, I would forget to apply cologne on myself when I'm in the room. So on the way out, I can actually look at it and be reminded like, oh, I actually forgot to apply some cologne. This is very, very convenient because I can grab it, spray it all over my body, and then just go out of the house and start my day. Moving on to this plant. This is a housewarming gift by Vindy, and it just brightens up the whole living area and also the sideboard area. Now let's move on to my favorite, favorite space. It's where all the magic happens, and the wizard is Daryl alone. I just observes and supervise most of the time because he is so good at cooking and I'm not. This whole kitchen is actually Daryl's idea, and I really love this quartz countertop. It matches this one. Previously, this was a cabinet, and we just broke it down and made it into a dish drainer to put all of our dishes. Also designed by Daryl. I sound like I didn't do anything for this house, but I did. I decorated it, so we kind of complement each other. This sink was actually just a single sink, but we broke it and made it into a double so that we can do our dishes together. And you know, efficiency is key in this home. This air fryer was gifted to us by his mom. This toaster from Amy before she moved to London. And this very pretty kettle. It was pretty expensive, but it was Daryl's idea because it had this rose gold trimming. And then this is what I call the non-halal rack. It's not mine because I don't really drink. It's all Daryl's. And then I decorated that part with another droopy looking plant. And then this is actually my favorite section because this is where I make my friends coffee. I make them sit down over here. This countertop was one of the best decisions that we've ever made because this is where we cook, this is where we prepare the ingredients to cook, and also sometimes we would sit down here and do our work. Sometimes in the morning I would just have a cup of coffee, reply emails, and also read my Bible from time to time. And this is the dining area. Usually it doesn't look like this, it's pretty much empty, but I'm just doing it for the video for you guys. And these chairs, we actually got them separately from the table. We bought the chairs first at Heath's, and we got this for a very, very good price. We only got this for 500 ringgit. Because usually for this kind of quality and wood, you probably have to get them for 800 ringgit to 1,000. And this is the living room area. This is where we talk to our friends when they come over, where we chill, sometimes take naps, watch TV. And this couch is the best thing ever because it's so comfortable and it looks perfect for the size of our living room. This couch, the coffee table, the TV console, and also the bed in the guest bedroom, it all amounted to 6,000 ringgit, which is an absolute steal. I decorated this couch with some pillows. It's very, very soft. I really like leaves and I really like plants, and that's why I gotta have them on my pillow as well. Got this chevron rug from Easy Buy, and this poof is from, I think, Shopee or Lazada. This rug, I got it from IKEA as well. And moving on to the TV console. Decorated it with a lot of frames, little knickknacks, fake terrarium. Almost everything is from Huga and IKEA. This frame is also from Huga, but instead of putting a photo, I thought of framing up my favorite Bible verse. It serves to remind us to be strong because all things are possible. Well, these succulents, I got them from IKEA, but instead of the normal brown pot, I moved them to this marble pot. I know it's not the proper way because to have plants you need like holes underneath, but you know, it's still alive, so I think it's okay lah. And at the end of the TV console, I have this cage, not for a bird, but for my candle. It's the wood, sage, and sea salt. I actually tailor all the scents in my home according to the areas. And for this one, I chose wood, sage, and sea salt because it matches the interior of my living room, the furniture as well. So when you're kind of chilling here, watching TV, you feel very cozy, very homey, kind of like a feeling you're in a cabin. A few months ago, I was just walking on the street and I came across Floristica, and this guy only cost about 30 ringgit, so I had to buy it. Although it's a bit thin and it has been like that since the day I bought it. Hasn't really been growing. We named it Christmas. Not sure if it will last until Christmas, but we must all have faith. I think in the future I would buy a bigger plant and move this to the balcony. Now moving on to the guest bathroom. So when our guests come in to relieve themselves, they can pamper their hands with this Blackberry and Bay body and hand wash. This one I got from Daiso. It was only 5.90. And moving up, you can see this mirror. This garland of leaves, I also got it from Daiso and it only cost me 5.90. On the top shelf, we have tissue for your bum bum. Second shelf, tissue for your face. If you feel a bit more, you know, environmentally friendly, you can use a towel. On the last shelf, I also provide cotton buds, cotton pads, just in case you need to remove your makeup, and also some Jo Malone goodies. Oh, hi there. It's you again. Okay, I'm just kidding. Okay, this is the guest bedroom. We didn't turn it into an office or anything because Daryl and I, we like to have friends over, relatives over. Didn't really decorate the study much because I just want them to have the space to put all their stuff here, their makeup, anything at all. This is drawn by Limzy. Of course, I got it from the Pandora event that I attended. This one is actually a tissue box. It fits really well here, so I didn't want to move it anymore. And this is a very cute Pooh plush toy that I got from Disney. Knowing me, I love my florals, I love plants. You gotta have flowers in the room, so these are hydrangeas, but the color is more earthy and it suits the entire vibe of the room. And last but not least, we have this painting gifted to me by a longtime friend. It's a park in Paris. Moving on to the bed, the most important part. I wanted it to be very cozy so that they would feel very at home. When they come over, they can have a cup of tea. This throw, it really changes up the entire mood of the room. And to add a pop of color, I also purchased this pillow from Kaisun and this fluffy guy right here. I got it from Kaisun as well. Oh my gosh, I have the price tag. It's just very comfortable looking at it and it's very soft as well. I have these artwork that I just ordered online and I framed it up. Next to the bed, we have the bedside table. I wanted to keep it very simple yet classy and I got this bunch of hydrangeas from Kaisun. You know, scents have the ability to make you feel very relaxed, very calm. So that's why for our guests, I also included this diffuser. It's the lime, basil, and mandarin, similar to the one on the sideboard. And also, if they want to try this scent, this is the silver needle tea. This is very limited edition. I don't think they make this anymore. I checked it and it was out of stock on the website. And this is the amazing part. Look, it doesn't fall because it has a very strong magnetic force on the cover. And if our guests would like to try it out, they can use it too. Now, last but not least, let's check out the master bedroom. But before we check out where I sleep and lay my head, we're gonna look at the master bathroom first. This entire section did not exist previously. The bathroom came very empty, just came with this sink right here. So this was designed by Daryl as well. We like to have big mirrors and tall, because he's very tall. And we also have some storage space in here. I'm not gonna show you because it's pretty messy. This is the sink situation. So this area is where I usually, you know, freshen up, wash my face, brush my teeth, and also do my skincare regime. I've been trying this liquid facial soap from Clinique, toner from Kiehl's. I think I've actually introduced it to you guys in one of my favorites videos, I think. We have the serum from Fresh. Lately, I've been using the Clinique Moisture Surge. I've been using it so much in Perth because it was really dry. And I've been trying the cleansing balm from Clinique. And this is my favorite overnight mask from Fresh. Since I didn't want to crowd this entire rack with too many products, that's why I store most of them here. I just want to keep it more minimalist and decorated it with all these Jo Malone bottles. One of the most important parts of my day is shower time, and that's why I want to feel very relaxed when I do that. Daryl actually laughed when he saw this, but I think it's such a great idea. When you're showering, you feel like you're a part of nature. Please leave it in the comment section down below telling him it's an amazing idea, okay? And these are my favorite products to use currently. They're from Lush. This is the shampoo, and then the body wash, and this is the hair treatment. And of course, if you've watched my favorite videos, you would know that I love, love, love this Rose Argan body conditioner. On days where I feel very atas, I would just go for this one. This is the lime, basil, and mandarin body and hand wash, and it smells amazing. And over here we have this bathroom mat/rug. It's one of my favorite pieces because it's so fluffy. Ah! Last but not least, it's the master bedroom. And this is the place where I just rest and unwind, pamper myself with makeup, skincare. Ah, this is my sanctuary. Walking in this area, we have this full-length mirror that I got from IKEA a long time ago, since my uni days. So it has followed me for a very long time. I placed it here so that I can do, you know, a quick check on my outfit before I head out. And I just decorated this area with this artwork. I purchased it online and it was only 5 ringgit. And this artificial plant, I'm so happy with this purchase because it was very, very cheap as well. It's so luscious. I got it from Easy Buy. It looks real because of the different shades of green. And I was just very happy when it arrived. And this is just the star of the bedroom. It's a painting. And it's from Limzy as well. I'm so speechless whenever I look at it because I think she's just so talented. This illustration just encapsulates me and Daryl's relationship because he used to be a dancer. So we both dancing through life together. Get it? Symbolism? No? Okay. Just me then. I don't know why I walked out of frame. I wasn't finished yet. Okay, I also decorated the top of this drawer with this wildflower and weeds collection bottles from Jo Malone. I spritz it sometimes. Look at the packaging, it's very nice. It goes very well with the whole vibe of my room. And moving on, we have this. This is very special. It's a room spray. If I want the whole room to smell a bit more citrusy, I would spray this. It's lime, basil, and mandarin as well. And over here, we have my favorite lipsticks. Besides hydrangeas, I also love peonies. And these are artificial because peonies cannot last longer than a week. And when they die, I feel very sad. So to avoid that situation, I just got myself some artificial ones. Here we have my vanity drawer, and it's the Alex drawer from IKEA as well. Look at all of my lip products. If you want to see vanity tour, just let me know in the comment section down below. And this is my vanity corner, if you may. This vanity mirror, I actually stumbled across an Instagram called Vanity Mirror Mura because I actually typed in Vanity Mirror Mura. I love it. It's very affordable and it's the perfect size. It's not too small, it's not too big. And it came with all the bulbs to match the vanity set. I purchased this chair from SSF. It was very affordable. It was only 199 ringgit. I included this furry cushion as well to add texture to the chair. On my vanity table, I like to keep it simple because I don't like clutter. I have con butts, con pads, eyelash curler, my makeup brushes, and this marble holder. I actually got it from Easy Buy. And this one is from a PR kit that I've received. Still don't know what to put inside yet. We have my first ever scent from Jo Malone. Is the Peony and Blush Suede scent. Last but not least, we have the bed, and this is my absolute favorite furniture of the entire house because it is so comfortable. We got this bed from Serta. We spent a lot of money on it, and I've never spent so much on a bed before, but it's gonna last us for a very long time. So it's a good investment. We even had a couple of friends who came over and tested it out. They did not want to get up from the bed, and I just decorated it with a throw. On this side of the bed, we have a bunch of eucalyptus, some books that we can read before hitting the hay. On this side of the bed, we have this ball-looking flower. I'm not sure what it's called. If any of you know, please leave it in the comment section down below. I just wanted to keep it very gold and pristine, and that's why I use all these gold items. This is the orange bitter candle that I really like from Jo Malone. Paired it with the White Moss and Snowdrop cologne. I placed it here for decorative purposes because I like the gold cap of the bottle, and also I included some of my gold accessories to add some more texture to the entire bedside table. And that's a wrap of my first home tour. Thank you so much for tuning in and watching till the end. To be honest, I actually learned so much from this experience, because having a home on my own, that means I have to call the shots, I have to decide, I have to search for the cheapest option, the best option. It was definitely an enjoyable one. I will try my best to link all the items and the products featured in this video in the description box down below so you can check them out. And if you have any home decor questions that you would like to ask me, feel free to leave it in the comment section down below. I will try my best to help you. Thank you so much for watching once again. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, please join the family and be a Chayang. Click on the subscribe button. And if you like this video, click on the like button as well. Leave a comment in the comment section down below. I would really, really love to read them. And until the next video, I'll see you guys soon. Bye, Chayang!